Namaste student, today I am going to start on the topic from chapter wave, and this is part 136. So previously we have already learned what is wave motion, what is wave equation and their characteristics. So today we will going to learn reflection of waves. So reflection, just a second. Reflection of waves, that means when if a pulse of wave or a wave meets a rigid boundary, that gets reflected in echo. So a part of incidence wave is reflected and a part of transmitted to the second medium. One is reflected and one is transmitted. The part which is reflected means the incident obliquely on the boundary between two different media. The transmitted wave is called the reflected wave. The incident and reflected and refracted waves obey Snell's law of refraction. An incident and reflected waves obey usual law of reflection. So reflection, this is reflection and refraction. Traveling the pulse is moving towards the non-absorptive pole, so it can say that the displacement of connecting point at the boundary must be zero. So the principle of superposition, the reflected wave have equal amplitude as well as phase difference of pi. So if this if the phase difference is pi, then we can say that this is a completely free to move, and reflected pulses have the same phase and amplitude as the incident pulse. The net maximum displacement at the boundary will be twice the amplitude of each pulse. So here, if the traveling wave is x equals to yt, y equals to xt, then we can say that it is equals to a sine kx minus omega t. At the rigid boundary, the reflected wave it is given by y equals to xt and equals to a sine kx minus omega t plus pi. So a sine kx minus omega t, because we can write this one, because sine pi equals to minus, so we can write that minus a sine kx minus omega t. So at the open boundary, the reflected wave is given by y equals to xt and it is equals to a sine kx minus omega t plus 0. So it is equals to, we know that answer is 1, so we can say that a sine kx minus omega t. At a rigid boundary, y equals to y dash equals to y plus y, which is equals to 0 for at all time. So we can say standing wave, so we can say that this is for the rigid boundary, y dash equals to y plus y. So standing waves and normal mode. Standing waves is what? New sets of waves which is formed when two sets of progressive waves trains of a same type, both transverse or both longitudinal waves in the same amplitude and same time period and frequency and wavelength, traveling with same speed along the same straight line in opposite direction, which is superimposed and called the standing waves or stationary waves. So the resulting waves do not propagate in any direction, that there is no transfer of energy in the medium. When we are considering reflection at two or more boundaries, then we can say the interference pi. So we can say that there is an interference between incident and reflected wave, which is a steady wave pattern will set up on the string. So such waves pattern are called the standing waves or stationary waves. So if y1 equals to xt equals to a sine kx minus omega t, and y2 equals to xt equals to a sine or kx plus omega t. So y equals to y1 plus y2, which is equals to a sine kx minus omega t plus sine kx plus omega t. So this is the resultant wavelength, which is 2a sine kx, 2a sine kx cos omega t. So here the amplitude of the standing wave is 2a sine kx, and thus we can see the wave pattern, the amplitude varies from point to point, and the element of the string which is oscillate with the same angular frequency omega, and the time period so here is no phase difference, and we can see that it is stationary and the amplitude is fixed at a given location, but different at different location. Normal modes, points having zero amplitude are called nodes. So the points having largest amplitude are called antinode. So the significant features of stationary waves is that the system which is cannot oscillate with any arbitrary frequency, but is characterized by a set of normal natural frequency or normal modes oscillation. So for here we can see it is determined by the normal modes for a stretched string which is fixed at a both end. The amplitude is zero for values or kx that gives sign kx which is equals to zero. Now sin kx equals to what? Zero. So k equals to n pi, and n and the value of n is 0 1 2 3 and so on. Here k equals to n pi, and here n pi divided by 2 pi by lambda, so which is equals to n pi equals to n pi by 2. So the value of n is 0 1 2 3 and so on. The first node is formed at x equals to 0, and the second node is formed x equals to lambda by 2 and so on. The distance between two successive nodes is lambda by 2. So this is the distance between two successive nodes. And for the antinode, the maximum value of amplitude is 2a, which occurs for value of kx that gives sine kx that mod which is equals to 1. So k equals to n plus half whole pi, and the value of n equals to 0 1 2 3 and so on. So for the so for the antinode, x equals to 2n plus 1 lambda by 4. 2x plus 1 into lambda by 4. So n equals to 0, 1, 2 and so on. The value of k equals to 2 pi by lambda. The amplitude which is maximum for this position of the string and this behaves like x equals to lambda by 4 and x equals to 3 lambda by 4 and so on. So distance between two consecutive antinode is lambda by 2. So this is the distance between two consecutive antinodes. Next, vibration of strings fixed both ends. So if a string fixed with the both end, then one end be at x equals to 0 and other end x equals to L. So according to that, n equals to n pi by lambda. So there is a possible wavelength of stationary waves are lambda equals to 2L by n, or the value of n equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on. So for the corresponding frequencies are frequency of the vibration. So this nu equals to, so n b by 2L, where n equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on. So mode of vibration, what is the mode of vibration? The manner in which the strings vibrates and gives rise to the standing waves is known as mode of vibration of a string. So first mode of vibration is in which strings will vibrate in one or one segment or the lowest possible natural frequencies is called fundamental modes or first harmonic. So n equals to lambda 1 by 2 and it will going to be changed. Second mode of vibration which is called string with will vibrate in two segments is called the second harmonic or first overtone, which is n equals to 2. So n equals to n lambda by 2. So here L equals to lambda by 2 and V and obviously it will going to change, so NV by 2L. So if this is the third mode, so here this will be changed. This will be we have to multiply by 3 because N equals to C. This is called the third harmonic and so on. So this is the diagram. The variation of the string will be superposition of different nodes and the and some modes different modes and some modes may be strongly excited and some less. So this is all about my today's topic. Tomorrow I am going to start another topic from this chapter. Thank you, student, for watching this video.